And we're not necessarily looking for life that looks like us, that thinks and walks and talks. The fact that you can have life even as a very, very small, one-celled organism living someplace else is exciting. We're looking for just a simple form of life. I'm a planetary geologist. A planetary geologist looks at the rocks on other planets in an attempt to understand what the history of that planet might have been. For example, I am very interested in Mars, the red planet. The planet Mars had water at one time, but over a period of time, the water was lost, and what you have left behind are deposits that are represented by something that you know every day, halite. This mineral, which we look at as a common table salt, tells us a lot about what happened in the past, whether it be our planet Earth or another planet. Because associated with these very salty bodies are bacteria, very small microbes that are adapted to living in these very salty environments. If we have bodies of water that are salty, and we know that there are bacteria that love this stuff, then we say, well, microbes on Earth survive this, and oh my gosh, we now have bacteria that have been able to survive in a similar environment on another planet. And this is exciting because it tells us that life is not unique. It can occur in a lot of interesting and odd places. I was very lucky as an undergraduate to have a woman who thought I had some ability, and it started off in a basic biology class of being able to pigeonhole or identify organisms fairly easily. If you had told me at that point that I could do it, I would have said, no, this is too scary. I don't think I can handle it. But you take it one step at a time. I started off as somebody studying fossils. And then I had an opportunity come to work with NASA. That's when I became more interested in the origin of life, how it changed over time, and I moved into geology. Because in order to understand that, you have to understand geology. Well, the important thing about Earth is it serves as a model. You can think about it as a role model for helping us to understand what happens on other planets, such as Mars. I'm very interested in the Dead Sea. The Dead Sea is one of the saltiest bodies here on Earth, so it doesn't represent Mars as it is today, but it represented Mars at one point when it was losing all of its water. So if we find life in the Dead Sea in the form of a microbe, we can say that it's highly likely that at some point a similar kind of microorganism or microbe was living in Mars in a very similar salty water. We have not landed on any other planet. We have to rely on machines that send us back information. We're looking at rocks and what they're made up of. We as human beings should constantly be looking around us and looking at how life can be different. I've looked at the Dead Sea, I've looked at Mono Lake, I've looked at another area in the Bahamas, but there's so many other places I would also like to see and compare and see how they differ. I wish I could actually go someplace off this planet and explore. It would be so exciting.